Hello friends, welcome back to All About Structural Analysis and Design. So this series is about analysis of indeterminate structures, and in that we are going through the slope deflection method. So we have already solved the one problem on slope deflection method where both the ends were fixed one. So this problem is having a little bit variation. Okay, so here one end is fixed and another end is hinged. Okay, so the question given is analyze the continuous beam by slope deflection method, and also we have to draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. So again, this is a continuous beam having two span. Okay, so end A is fixed and C is hinged, and in this particular beam there are two types of loading. One is point load, another one is uniformly distributed load, that is UDL. So in our previous problem, the continuous beam was having the entire UDL of different intensity, whereas in this problem there is a slight variation. We are having one point load. Okay, and point load is acting at the center, so there may be one more point load where it is not acting at the center of the span. Okay, so those particular examples also we will see how to solve it. So friends, if you are going through this particular series and if you have liked this series, please like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe All About Structural Analysis and Design, and also press the bell icon for the latest notifications of my videos in civil and structural engineering. Okay, so let's start with this particular today's problem. Here in this video, the span is having 5 meter span AB. Okay, so the point load is placed at the center, so it means 2.5 meters and 2.5 meters it is divided, and another span BC is having 6 meters. And also we have to remember the last problem I was entirely constant, so but here in this problem AB is having the value of I and BC is having the value of 3i. So this also we have to take care while solving the problem. Okay, so now as usual we have to start this problem with the finding out the fixed end moments, and we will find it out one by one and span by span. So we'll start with today's calculations. So now fixed end moments. Okay, as you know, there will be 4 fixed end moments for this beam. First is MFAB, MFBA, MFBC, and MFCB. Okay, so there are total 4 moments. So I will be giving the link in the description box of my previous videos. Okay, so that you can see it, and you can once again go through that video and come back to this video, and you will be having a clear knowledge. So what we are actually doing in this particular problems. Okay, so now MFAB. So UDL was having WL square by 12. Okay, so last problem entire 4 fixed end moments with respect to WL square by 12 was there. Here now we have to remember AB is having a point load at the center, so fixed end moments changes. So for this particular type of loading, the fixed end moment is given as minus WL by 8. Why minus? Because MFAB is going anti-clockwise and W is 100. Okay, so L, the entire span we have to take, that is 5 meters and divided by 8. So minus 100 into 5 divided by 8 will result into minus 62.5 kilonewton meter. So now similarly MFAB is over, we have to calculate now MFBA. So this particular moment we have to calculate. So MFBA. So now it will be clockwise moment. Okay, so every fixed end moment will be anti-clockwise and clockwise. So anti-clockwise we have taken negative, so clockwise we are going to take positive, and the formula remains same again. So 100 into 5 divided by 8, so positive 62.5 kilonewton meter. So this is the fixed end moment for the span AB. Okay, so now similar way we have to calculate now fixed end moment for BC, and one will be anti-clockwise, that is MFBC, and another will be clockwise, that is MFCB. And the intensity or the formula is given for the UDL, that is WL square by 12. And the intensity of UDL is 24 kilonewton per meter. So MFBC, always remember we are going span by span. Entire continuous beam we are not taking, we are taking span by span and calculating all the values. So MFBC will be minus WL square by 12. Okay, so here W is 24 given, minus into the 6 square divided by 12. So minus 24 into 6 square divided by 12 will result into minus 72 kilonewton meter. So now similar way MFCB, okay, the last fixed end moment. And also I've done the video of extend moment, so that also you can check out. So all the series I have placed in the playlist of slope deflection method, and also I'll be giving in the link in the description box. Okay, so you can check out the previous videos. So this will be positive WL square by 12. So 24 into 6 square divided by 12 will result into positive 72 kilonewton meter. So our first step is over now for calculating the fixed end moments for the given loading conditions. So now we have to see where the theta will be 0 and where theta is not equal to 0. So our basic principle of fixed beam says wherever there is fixed beam, wherever there is fixed end, theta will be 0. So now we have to check out where all fixed end fixed ends are there. So here in this beam only one fixed end is there, that is theta A. Okay, at point A the beam is fixed, so therefore theta A will be 0, means rotation will be 0 at point A, whereas B and C the rotations will be there, so theta B and theta C will not be 0. And also anything they have not mentioned about the delta or about the sink, so therefore delta will be 0 in this particular case. So now we will write down here, now as end A is fixed, therefore theta A is equals to 0 and delta is not given, therefore delta we are considering it as 0, because this becomes very important when you are solving with the help of slope deflection equation, which is the next step in this particular problem. So once we are clear with the fixed end moments and also with the boundary conditions, whatever with respect to the beam is given, then we can go to the slope deflection equations. So we'll come back to this beam again. So we have to calculate the moment at A, that is MAB. At B there will be two moments, MBA this side and MBC another side, and here there will be one moment, that is MCB. So these four moments we have to calculate with the help of slope deflection equation. So we will write down the first moment slope deflection equation for the moment MAB. So MAB is equals to, so now slope deflection equations we have seen. So first comes the fixed end moment, that is MFAB, okay, plus 2EI by L, 2 theta A plus theta B minus 3 delta by L. Okay, so in this now we have seen theta A and delta is 0, so the only remaining will be theta B in this particular equation. So MAB equals to MFAB we had calculated and it is minus 62.5 plus 2EI. So we have to be careful about the taking of I value, and in for the span AB the I value was 1, so we need not worry about the substituting here in the EI. So 2EI by the span is 5 meters, so 2EI by 5 theta B. So we will simplify this equation, and this equation will become MAB is equals to minus 62.5, okay, so plus 0.4 EI theta B. So this will be equation number 1. So this is the first moment equation we are getting with the help of slope deflection equation. So now similarly we will find out for MBA. So MFBA plus 2 EI by L, 2 theta B plus theta A minus 3 delta by L. So in this again theta A and delta is 0. So this is positive 62.5 plus 2EI by 5 meter is the span for AB. So 2 times theta B. So the final equation for MBA will be 62.5 plus 0.8, 2 to the 4, 4 divided by 5 is 0.8 EI theta B. So this will be equation number. Now similarly we will calculate the moment for MBC. So MBC is equals to MFBC plus 2EI by L, 2 theta B plus theta C minus 3 delta by L. So we have to remember theta B and theta C is not equal to 0. In this case only delta is 0. So we will substitute. So MBC is equals to MFBC is minus 72 plus here we have to remember the I value is 3 for the span BC given. So 2E3I divided by the span was 6 meters. Okay, so 2 theta B plus theta C, delta is 0. So we can simplify this equation, minus 72. So this will become, just check out, 2 3 is 6, 6 into 2 is 12, 12 divided by 6 is 2. So plus 2 EI theta B plus, this will become 1. So EI theta C. So this will become equation number 3. And similarly, MCB. So MFCB plus 2 EI by L, 2 theta C plus theta B minus 3 delta by L. So again substitute, here it is positive 72. So this will become 3I again, because the I value is given in the problem. So 6 is the span. So 2 theta C plus theta B and delta is 0. So MCB will be 72, the final equation, plus this will become 2 EI theta C plus EI theta B. So this will become equation number 4. So once you have got all the 4 equations, your next step is to go back to the beam and check out where the equilibrium conditions can be obtained. So now equilibrium equations is nothing but wherever the moment is 0, those particular points you have to select. So the fixed end, the moment is not 0, so you cannot select the A point. So B point is hinge and moment at hinge is 0. So what we can do is, for equilibrium condition, MBA and MBC equals to 0 is first equilibrium condition, and also C is hinge, so MCB is equals to 0, that also becomes the equilibrium conditions. So two equilibrium conditions we can use here. Okay, so now equilibrium conditions. So first one we will do it. So at point B, MBA plus MBC equals to 0. So that is nothing but equation number 2 and equation number 3. So we will take down, MBA was the equation having 62.5 plus 0.8 EI theta B. MBC is here minus 72 plus, 2 times EI theta B plus EI theta C is equals to 0. So now you can rearrange the terms here. So 2.8 EI theta B, then will come theta C, that is only 1 EI theta C, minus 9.5 is equals to 0. So this will become equation number 5. Okay, so we have rearranged how it is required to substitute in the calculator. So now one more equilibrium condition was at point C, okay, and that is nothing but only one moment equation. So MCB is equals to 0. So MCB is this equation number 4, that is 72 plus 2 EI theta C plus EI theta B is equals to 0. So now again we will rearrange it and we will get the equation, final equation. So here in terms of theta B, first term is the EI theta B, then will come theta C, this one. So 2 EI theta C minus, plus 72, then is equals to 0. So this is the format which you require to solve the equation in the calculators. Okay, so now what we have to do, we have to solve the equation 5 and 6, get the values of theta B and theta C, and then substitute back in 1, 2, 3, 4 equations and get the moment values. Solving 5 and 6. Okay, so when you input those particular values or the equations in the calculator, so you'll be getting the values EI theta B as 19.78 and EI theta C is equals to minus 45.89. So these are the two values you are getting. So now to get the final moments, substitute above values in equation 1, 2, 3, and 4. So once you substitute these two values in the all the four equations, then you'll be getting the final moment. So those final moments are MAB, you'll be getting minus 54.58 kilonewton meter. Okay, then MBA, you'll be getting 78.324 kilonewton meter. Then MBC, you will be getting minus 78.324 kilonewton meter, and as usual MCB will be zero because the moment was zero for that particular hinge. So these are the final moments. So once you get the final moments, then you can go to draw bending moment diagram. And as I had told, you have to draw the bending moment diagram for the loading conditions first, then you have to overlap these values on the bending moment diagram and get the final bending moment diagram. So now what we will do, we will draw the first the bending moment diagram with respect to the loading conditions. So this is your baseline. Okay, so then the loading condition first was the point load. So for the point load, it is WL/4. So W is so just again we'll see here the beam. So this is a point load. So WL/4 will be the bending moment value for the point load, and WL²/8 will be for the UDL. So with this loading conditions, you have to draw it. WL/4 is 100 into 5 divided by 4, and WL²/8 will be 24 into 6² / 8. So the values is 125 for point load and 108 for UDL. So with respect to that one, we will draw here. So 125 is for point load, WL/4. You can just check out with your calculators, and it will be a triangular BMD. Then you can come back to this point. And one more is with the UDL for 6 meter span, WL²/8. It is 108, and it is parabolic. So this is your SOM knowledge. So with respect to that, you can draw it. So you can write down here 125. Kilonewton meter, and this is 108 kilonewton meter. So this is with respect to the loading conditions. Now what you have to do, you have to overlap these values, and this MAB, the starting point here AB is minus 54.58, so it will go down. So we are overlapping it, so it will again come up. So somewhere here we will mark it. So this will be 54.58 kilonewton meter. So now next value is 78.324 MBA, that is positive. Positive is upside. So here greater than 54, you have to mark somewhere here. So we will mark it here. Then MBC, so the, for this part it is negative. Again it will go down, it will come and overlap and meet at same point. So you can write down here 78.324 kilonewton meter. And next MCB is zero, so it will come and meet here. So you have to join these points now. Okay, and this to this directly zero, so it should be straight line. You can draw with the scale and pencil. Okay, so now whatever is below this line, it is negative, above this line is positive. Okay, so this is how you will be drawing the bending moment diagram for the given continuous beam with respect to loading condition and the moments you have obtained. So this completes the bending moment diagram. Now for drawing the shear force diagram, you need the reactions. So now reactions we will calculate. So now reactions with the help of the moments, okay, which we have got, and with respect to the loading conditions and the vertical reactions, we will draw the shear force diagram, and before that we will calculate the reactions. So here it is hinged. So all the things you have to show now, whatever you have done. So here there is one vertical reactions VA. So for this again VB, and this VC. So this actually you have done in strength of materials to finding out the reactions. So once again I will show you. So 24 kilonewton per meter is the load given, and here there is point load 100 kilonewton. Okay, so now this is for the span, I think 5 meters. Okay, so this is 6 meters, so So this is 2.5 meters, this is 2.5 meters. So this is your the given beam. So now what you have calculated? You have calculated the moments. So MAB was minus, so that is anti-clockwise, 54.58 kilonewton meter. Here it was positive, so that is clockwise, 78.324. For this one, negative, 78.324. And this was zero. So now what you have to do while calculating the reactions, also span by span you have to go, don't consider the entire span. So individually we will calculate for span AB. So these things are A, B and C. So first we will go for AB and then we will go for BC. So before doing this one, you have to remember the sign conventions, the moment directions. So if you are taking the section for the left hand side, clockwise is positive. And if you are taking the section right hand side, anti-clockwise is positive. Okay, so this you have to remember because we are taking the moment at B. So for that, AB span will be left hand side. So clockwise will be positive moments. And when you are taking the moment at B for the span BC, so it will be right hand side. So anti-clockwise will be positive. So these things you have to remember and you have to solve the equations and get the reactions value. Okay, so now sigma MB is equals to zero. Okay, so treating each span separate. Okay, so treating each span separate, you have to calculate the vertical reactions. So with respect to this point B, if you are taking for span AB, so for span AB we will calculate first. So when you take the point at B, so VA is rotating clockwise and clockwise moments are positive when you are taking the section left hand side. So VA into phi will be the positive value. And if you consider the next term, that is moment here, 54.58, which is rotating anti-clockwise. And anti-clockwise rotations are negative for the left hand side section. So minus 54.58. Then this 100 kilonewton is moving again this anti-clockwise at the span 2.5 meter, okay, at a distance 2.5 meter. So minus 100 into 2.5. And then the last term, that is this moment, it is rotating again this clockwise, 78.324. Don't consider this moment, okay? So this moment will be for span BC. So we are not considering the span BC now. So only we are considering the span AB. So for this AB span, this 78.324 is rotating clockwise. And clockwise is positive if you are considering left-hand side section. So plus 78.324. So all the things are now taken. So VB we cannot take because VB into 0 will become 0. So we are not considering this VB. So this will become is equals to 0. And when you simplify this, you will be getting VA is equals to 45.25 kilonewton. So this is how you have to calculate the vertical reactions, that is VA, first with the help of span AB. So once you calculate for the span AB, then go to span BC. Okay, so here also we are taking at point, the moment at point B is a zero. Okay, so again sigma MB is equals to zero, but this time for span BC. So for span BC, what all things comes? VC, this moment zero, this 24 UDL, then this moment. Okay, so one by one we will see. So now when you consider this at this point B and you consider this span BC, so now it will become right hand side section, and right hand side section anti-clockwise moments are positive. So if you take the section take the value VC, which is rotating at a 6 meter distance, it is going anti-clockwise and anti-clockwise is positive. So VC into 6, okay, this zero moment is zero, we will not consider. Then 24 is going this downward side and it is rotating clockwise. So 24 into 6, okay, so into 3, because it is UDL, first you have to convert it into point load, that is 24 into 6, and it is at the center of span and then rotating at a distance of 3 meters. So it is clockwise, so that's why it becomes negative. So 24 into 6 into 3. Then the 78.324 moment is rotating anti-clockwise and anti-clockwise is positive. So plus 78.324 is equals to 0. So when you simplify, you will be getting VC is equals to 58.324 946 kilonewton. So this is your second vertical reaction, that is VC. Okay, so now only remaining unknown is VB, so that you can do it with respect to vertical loading system. So now what all vertical loads are there? This is the VA, then this 100 kilonewton is going downward, so minus 100 plus VB minus 144 is nothing but 24 into 6, so that is downwards. Okay, plus VC is equals to 0. So now you know in that VA and VC you will be getting VB. So once you simplify this, so VB is equals to 139.80 kilonewton. So this is how, so this is the basic method to find out the reactions for the beam. Okay, so I hope this calculation is clear. So then we will go to draw the shear force diagram. So for this also you will have one baseline like this. Okay, so the first value VA was 45.25 kilonewton and it is positive, so it will go upside. Okay, so this is 45.25, and then you carefully check here, after this there is no loads. Okay, and directly the load is 100 kilonewton acting after the span 2.5 meters. So till 2.5 there will be no loading, so straight line. Okay, next, after drawing this straight line, then the load comes, that is 100 kilonewton, and it is going downwards. So what you can do, so you can here, you can mention here first 45.25 value. So 45.25 minus 100, because 100 is going downwards, so minus 100 will become here, come here, and this value will be 54.75. so again for 2.5 meters there is no load. Okay, if you see the beam here, there is no load. Okay, then comes VB. So VB is 139.80 positive. So here minus 54.75 plus 139.80, so 85.05 value will be getting. So you can, here you can draw here once again to the positive side. Okay, so this will be 85.05 kilonewton, so that is positive. So after this VB there is UDL. Okay, so that intensity is 24 into 6, that is minus 144. So that somewhere 58 you will be getting the value. So this value and this particular line you have to join like this. Okay, then once you get this 58.95 negative, so the last reaction was VC, and that VC is 58.946. so this 58.95, it will coincide for the positive value, and you will be getting here 0. So this is how you have to draw the shear force diagram with respect to the reactions whatever you have calculated. Okay, so all the values are in kilonewton. So this will be positive, negative, positive, negative. So this is how the complete beam can be analyzed with the help of slope deflection method, and with your basic of engineering mechanics and SOM, you can draw the shear force and bending moment diagram. I hope this video was clear, and if you have understood this video, you can like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe All About Structural Analysis and Design, and also press the bell icon for the latest notifications of my videos in civil and structural engineering. Thank you, friends.